This section should give an introduction to general use of AIS, use of AIS information in collision avoidance, use of AIS by Vessel Traffic Services, VTS, use of AIS in search and rescue. The IMO display requirement for AIS is minimum keyboard and display, MKD, that is, presentation of target information in alphanumeric format only. For most operators, this type of information is probably of very limited value, since this type of display is likely to still remain the cheapest for some years ahead. It is reasonable to assume that most ships will be equipped with this type of AIS display. The question is, therefore, of how much use will this type of AIS be to the officer on watch? Until more experience with AIS has been gained, this question will remain unanswered. COLREG Rule 7, Risk of Collision, states that every vessel shall use all available means appropriate to the prevailing circumstances and conditions to determine if risk of collisions exists. If there is any doubt, such risk shall be deemed to exist. The COLREGs oblige ships to apply all available means to detect the danger of collision and to take preventive measures. One of these means, especially during reduced visibility, is shipborne radar. Another aid now available is AIS. AIS broadcasts the identity, position, heading, course over ground, speed over ground, and certain other relevant ship data at an update rate dependent upon the ship's speed or rate of turning during course alterations. The AIS performance surpasses shipborne radar in several respects. AIS aims to achieve a positional accuracy of better than 10 meters when associated with Differential Global Navigation Satellite System, DGNSS, corrections. This compares favorably with radar, whose accuracy is a function of frequency, pulse repetition rate, and antenna beam width, and which often achieves a positional accuracy of 30 to 50 meters. Due to higher positional accuracy and less need for plot filtering, the position and changes of course over ground can be presented with less delay than by radar. The AIS provides supplementary information about other vessels that is not readily available from radar, such as identity, heading, course over ground, COG, speed over ground, SOG, rate of turn, ROT, and navigational status. AIS is also less sensitive than radar to negative weather effects, such as heavy rain, snow, etc. AIS also has the capability to see around bends and corners. As long as AIS provides more accurate and complete information, the passing distance between vessels can be determined with greater accuracy and reliability. From the navigational status information available, any maneuvering restrictions on a vessel become evident immediately and can be taken into account. Since AIS provides information different from that provided by the shipborne radar, it is strongly recommended that AIS and radar be used together in order to enhance the available information. AIS can also assist in the identification of targets by name or call sign and by ship type and navigational status, thus reducing the requirement for verbal information exchange. This clearly shows a potential situation shortly after a target vessel, B, has executed a course change to starboard in order to obtain a safe CPA with own ship, A. The ARPA time filters used to stabilize the ARPA vector may cause an offset between the ARPA and AIS. This is why it's important for the officer on watch always to remember that the ARPA is an early warning device. A study made by the German Marine Board indicated that the so-called radar-assisted collisions occurred in restricted visibility when radar provided insufficient, incomplete, or ambiguous data. The study concluded that many of these collisions could have been avoided if the navigators involved had been able to access timely and dynamic information, position, heading, speed, and rate of turn, etc., on the other vessel involved. AIS in the ship-to-ship application can now provide such dynamic information accurately and at high update rates when target information is available on the ships involved. Hopefully, AIS will contribute to a reduction in collisions at sea. However, if the navigators don't take early actions whenever possible, we may soon see another member in the family of assisted collisions, namely AIS-assisted collisions. At present, radar is the main sensor of the VTS for detecting a ship. The VTS radar has almost the same errors in range and bearing resolution as all other radars, although it has a known position and is north-oriented without the errors of the compass involved. The limitations of the ARPA radar to track ships due to target swap to land, beacons, bridges, and other ships, makes the tracking facility in the ARPA VTS rather limited. Vessel traffic services are currently limited to tracking ships in a bay area or on approaches from the sea to a harbor. There is a requirement for improving the VTS so that it will be able to cover areas where radar coverage is almost impossible to achieve, identify radar echoes on the VTS radar automatically, interrogate ships for information regarding type of cargo, track with high update rate, know which port a ship is bound for, know the size and draft of ships in the vicinity, detect a change in a ship's heading almost in real time. The only AIS solution that could solve all the requirements of the VTS is a high update rate broadcast AIS with interrogation capabilities. In the near future, AIS as a part of aids to navigation will be available to the users. The establishment of a global AIS in general, or a land-based AIS reception network in particular, may actually mitigate the need for VTS in many areas. The cost of installing and maintaining an AIS network is negligible compared to that of a VTS radar network. Marine rescue and coordination centers operations would be much more efficient if they had every rescue craft fitted with AIS to quickly determine which ship is closest to a distress situation. During a search, all crafts could be tracked, enabling the Marine Rescue Coordination Center, MRCC, to monitor their progress, to direct available resources efficiently, and determine whether search coverage is without gaps.